solar panels and now massive batteries. Right now, Minnesota is in a race to build, test, and deploy large-scale battery plants.
Investigative reporter Ryan Ray shows us what's at stake here.
There is a critical need and a deadline fast approaching. This is all part of Minnesota's mandate, 100% clean energy by 2040. And we just traveled to one site, charging ahead. The expiration date on these smokestacks is staring Xcel Energy in the face.
We've got the coal facility that's in the process of retiring and coming offline by 2030.
The coal days at the Sherco power plant in Becker are over, and the new era has already begun.
This really is the kind of epicenter of our energy transition in Minnesota.
Solar panels now stretch as far as the eye can see. More than 1.5 million panels when it's all done, turning Sherco into the fifth largest solar farm in the United States. But there's one critical piece missing.
By the end of 2025, we expect to have the battery online.
We're talking batteries bigger than football fields. Xcel plans to build this one right next to its retiring coal plant. Then more than 3.5 hours southwest of here, there's another slice of land about to be transformed.
How big of a deal is this?
It's a big deal.
Private developer Invenergy is preparing to build a solar farm hooked to its own battery plant that will look similar to this one.
It's the first project that is being approved by the Minnesota PUC.
These projects are all part of the rush in Minnesota to meet a deadline 16 years away.
It's a law.
100% clean energy by 2040.
I think for the Midwest, we've been leading the way.
This graph shows the strides already made. Renewable energy like solar and wind account for about 1/3 of the electricity generated in the state. Natural gas is next, followed by coal with its steady decline down to 22%. And finally, nuclear is still generating around 21%. Experts say as coal continues to drop, batteries are a must.
These battery plants are not all that different than what most of us carry in our pockets every day, just on a massive scale. The whole point is to store the power from wind or solar and use it on a calm or cloudy day.
Energy storage is, in my mind, the key step in making that happen.
Logan O'Grady is the head of Mincia, an industry group pushing clean energy. But you don't have to take his word for it. Earlier this year, Siemens issued this nearly 100-page report outlining the dire need, calling energy storage essential for Minnesota's transition to carbon-free electricity. It found the state needs up to 2,800 megawatts of battery storage.
The key outcome of that study is this is not possible without energy storage. Energy storage technology, just like solar technology, is very nascent in Minnesota. It's very new.
So new, some critics argue, it's not yet proven.
While it's fun, it seems like a neat idea. The technology doesn't exist.
Republican and State Rep. Chris Wodzinski has been outspoken about Minnesota's aggressive 2040 clean energy plan.
We're being told that the battery capacity is what's going to make the difference. I mean, that is a pipe dream. That is really putting our economy at risk. People are not going to invest in a state that does not have safe, does not have affordable, and does not have reliable energy sources.
How do you respond to that criticism?
I think that's a really unfortunate way to look at it, and I think it's a big missed opportunity for them. What that tells me is he's not interested in supporting an up-and-coming industry.
Up-and-coming and evolving.
At Form Energy, we are using iron to reshape the way energy is stored.
Xcel's battery plant will test out this new technology that uses iron and rust and has a really big upside. It can hold a charge for up to 4 days. Traditional lithium battery plants only hold a 4-hour charge.
Has this technology been proven? Does it work?
We do think it's going to work, but that's also why we're piloting it, to figure out how exactly is it going to operate on the grid once it is operational, and how are we going to be able to control it?
Aaron Hansen at the University of Minnesota sees another upside.
It's really exciting for Minnesota, given that we mine for iron here.
Hansen's office conveniently has rooftop access to the solar panels that power nearly 20% of his building on a sunny day. For years, he's been talking about how batteries can help unleash the cheapest form of electricity, wind and solar.
So if batteries can enable more of that cheapest generation to be integrated into the grid, in theory, it should actually reduce the cost of electricity.
Swidzinski still doesn't buy it.
We will be talking about foundationally much higher energy prices. I think we'll be talking about why can't we entertain large industry in Minnesota? Why can't we grow jobs?
All of this while the clock is ticking. Just 16 years until 2040. That's all the time left to replace a power source that's been around for more than a half century.
Is it a reasonable goal?
I would say it's a reasonable goal just because what we've done already in the state, we have been a leader in deploying clean energy.
Do you think we're going to make it?
Yes. My optimism says that yes, we will.
There is a significant cost in building out these projects. Xcel received a nearly $6 billion tax credit in the Midwest area through the Inflation Reduction Act. It says it's passing that on to customers in the form of bill credits. They expect power bills to go up less than 1%. Ryan Raish, Eyewitness News on 45.